In a previous video, we looked at the Quinetic kinetic inline receiver, and we showed how you could change a simple one-way light switch in any room in the house, and we discussed it maybe being a bedroom, and make it two-way, two-way and intermediate. Actually, you could install one of these switches and five others, meaning you'd have control over the lighting point from six positions. And this is what we had, just to remind you. So we had these switches here, and I paired four of them of different styles in order to operate this lighting point, which was originally a one gang one way light switch, traditionally wired in, and we've now made it switch from four positions. I've had some questions. What happens when the power goes off? Does the pairing process forget? Well, actually, every time I operate the switch, the light goes off, but let's have a power cut. So if I come to the consumer unit and I knock off the breaker control in that circuit. So we've now lost the supply, and we come back in here. Obviously nothing's gonna work. Remember from that video, if you haven't already checked it out, I recommend you do, that these have no batteries in them. These three switches here obviously have no wires, and they work on kinetic energy. So when you make a movement, it creates energy and it sends a radio frequency into here, where we installed this here as a receiver with our line and switching line connections only, no neutral, and that replaced the switch that was already there. So let's say the power supply now comes back on. So let's bring the power supply back on. So the power's on. We can see the lights come back on and our original switch works, which is great, but has it kept that pairing process? It certainly has, in order that those are all paired. The other question I got was, let's say you wanted to unpair the system. Okay, so in other words, we'll go back to being just a simple one-way switch. That's not a problem either. We had to pair it by pressing and holding the switch for 6 seconds. If we hold it for about 12 seconds, it will actually clear all the pairing processes that have happened. So let's see that. So we press and hold the switch. We'll see it first of all go into pairing mode, but keep it holding down. So when it starts to flash, that's what we saw in the previous video. That's the pairing mode. So I now could add more switches, but we want to go beyond that. We want it to forget the switches that it's got here and just leave us with the original receiver one-way switch. So you see it's not flashing now. So it's cleared itself. Let's operate this switch. That's fine. So let's leave it on. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. We switch. Shall we just remind ourselves how we do the pairing process? So let's just pair it so it's two-way. So let's move these out of the way and let's go for one that looks very similar. We paired this first of all to make it two-way switching. Let's go through the process of pairing just one switch now. Press and hold for approximately 6 seconds. Wait for the lamp to start flashing. When it starts flashing, we're into the pairing process. Here we go. There we go. We're in the pairing process and we operate this switch. Remember, it's sending a radio frequency signal. Once it's picked it up, you can now see we've got two-way switching. Now, what's happened to these ones here that we were using before? Do these now work? Because it's unpaired, those switches do not work. So we've now got a simple two-way. As I said before, my daughter leaves this one on her bedside table. You could fix it to the wall. You could stick it to the wall in order that you could have your switch in a fixed position. But she quite likes having it by a bedside table. And this one fixed at the wall. Simple process, taking off a one gang one way switch, installing your inline receiver, which works with kinetic energy from here to the receiver. It's a Quinetic brand in order to make two-way switching. So hopefully that's answered the two questions that predominantly I got from the first video. What happens when the power goes off? They stay paired. What happens if I want to take off the switches? How do I unpair them? And obviously we cleared and unpaired it, and we repaired one as well. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.